Christians get so excited about all these things. Jesus said this, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through me." See, that's his words. And so as you take the word of Jesus as truth, then you know he is the only way to heaven. If you don't accept that word, then Jesus is just a religious artifact to you. I would tell you tonight, there are many people here, you see Jesus as just a story from history past that would love to tell you how he has invaded their life and blessed and guided and saved them. If you're one of those people tonight that can share that story, just quickly, not all at the same time, raise your hand. Yes, I've given my heart to life to Jesus. And you can talk to one of these people, they would be happy to share the good news. As you look at the candle of faith, the candle of Bethlehem, that point at which Jesus would come as Messiah and we would put our faith and trust in him, the candle of joy, the shepherd's candle, that great joy announcement that was given to them by the angels, the peace candle, the one that says that God has come to make peace with man and to set men at peace with himself. And then we come to the Christ candle. You notice it's larger than the others, and it's above all of them. And the reason for that is this candle is the fulfillment of the promise of the first advent. Now, what does that mean? When Jesus came the first time, the first advent, but Jesus is coming again. And so this candle not only stands for the fact that he came, but it also points to the prophecy that he's coming again. So today as we share this, we're not looking back at a historical event and just admiring that thing that has happened. But we're in this journey together as brothers and sisters in Christ, and we are looking toward the fulfillment as Jesus comes to receive those who are his very own. That candle stands for a sinless Son of God. It stands for a Savior. It is the light of his return. Now tonight, you have a candle, and I have a candle. And I want to tell you something about this because we're getting ready to do it. In fact, our deacons are going to kind of get in place here. We're about to start. Guys, you can just come up here to the front. This candle, as it represents Jesus, is the only source of the true life of salvation. I can do every good work in the world, and this candle will not light. I can say the right things. I can do good things. I can be a wonderful person. It won't light. There's only one true source of light that brings us in relationship to God. And for that to happen, what happens is I come to Jesus and I recognize that I need him. Why do I need Jesus? Because I'm a sinner. And sinners don't get into heaven. I need righteousness. I need light. I need life. And that is Jesus. He faced death and has been risen from the dead and lives forevermore. So as I acknowledge to him my sin and my need for a Savior, and I ask him to come in to save me, then I receive light and life from him. Now, as I go down here to these men, they're in the same situation. They need someone to tell them about Jesus. They need someone to bring them the light, even as someone had to bring me the light. And so tonight, what you're going to see is that the gospel message, the good news message about salvation through Jesus, is something that each person not only has to receive, but we're also called to pass it on. And so what I received about how to be saved, I pass on to another person, and as they respond, they pass it on. From generation to generation, this gospel message has been passed on. Tonight, we pray that if you've never received Jesus as Lord and Savior, that you will simply think toward God. We call that prayer. And ask him to forgive you of your sin and to come in and to save you, that you're giving him your life, that you might have his righteousness and holiness, and that he will be with you all of your life and throughout all eternity as he changes us day by day. Now, as these men come out and begin to light the candles, we do ask that you be careful of your children. We appreciate your concerns about safety. We're going to sing a song together, Silent Night. And as we finish the first verse, then we're going to ask the people on the back rows to make your way toward the door. As you get to the door, there'll be someone there to take your candle and place it in the container. We'll sing the first verse together, and then we'll depart, starting from the back.